8 factorial minus 6 factorial divided by 3 factorial times 5 factorial? Well, seems confusing, right? And I was just as confused when I first signed up for a math competition. But let me introduce myself. I am Andras Perjesi, a 12-year-old sixth grader from the Swiss International School Basel. Though I'm only 12, I'd like to share my experience and learning method with you. So, let's start. Like many other 12-year-olds, I'm mostly interested in playing video games and watching TV. I am not a math genius, and participating in these competitions was not the dream of my life when I first signed up. My parents explained to me that if I wanted to be an astrophysicist, well, my passion at that time, then I had to be really good at math. So honestly, they kind of forced me to do extra work and registered me to my first math competition. I was good at math in school, so I thought it would not be a problem for me to succeed in the competition. Well, sadly, to my surprise, it was. As the problems were handed out and the timer started, I scanned the pages in front of me. It was all gibberish to me. By the end of the competition, I realized I had only solved a few of the dozens of the problems provided. I was really disappointed and frustrated. The next year in school, we practiced on problems from the previous competitions, and our teacher showed us different methods on how to solve different types of problems by categorizing them. There are not actually millions of problems, but a few categories. Once I could figure out those, I could narrow down my approach. So, in a nutshell, what we basically need to do is practice the methods in advance, identify which method we should use for a certain type of problem, and then just use the well-known steps to resolve the issue. When working with word problems, I realized I needed to see through the text and determine the problem inside it. I determined that there were around 5 categories: the basic operations, addition, subtraction, etc., algebra, number sequences, and similarity problems, and tables. Using these, I can solve the problem hidden in the text. So basically, recognize, group, solve. I've also realized that I can use this method in other fields of life too. I, myself, hold a green belt in Aikido. But this achievement wouldn't have been possible without the usage of my method. You see, in Aikido, every technique is based on the basic movements and roles. So what I did was I first learned the basic moves, and then I learned to combine them with roles. So now, whenever I need to learn a new technique, I already know the beginning and all the steps because I just look at the name, match it with the basic moves and roles, and then I just need to learn the hand movements. Again, it has the same principle. Putting the movements into categories simplified the process of learning them. Now, to sum this up, I have found my own method, but there are no shortcuts. What I realized is that it wasn't about the math. It wasn't about the Aikido. It was about the commitment and putting in the hours. That is what ultimately made the difference. The fact that one size doesn't fit all. We need to embrace the journey. This was mine. What will yours be? Oh, by the way, the answer for the question at the beginning was 55.